double-double for New Zealand, our men's team today, joining our victorious women as Rugby Sevens World Champions. They'll hold the trophy as the best team on the planet for the next 4 years after successfully defending their title against England in San Francisco this afternoon. It's the men's first back-to-back title win, the same feat achieved by the women's team yesterday. A bit of context, and it really is All Black. New Zealand's status as the world's dominant rugby nation is now unchallenged. We're the men's and women's world champions in both the 15-a-side and 7-a-side game. One News' Guy Hevelt is covering the sevens, and he joins us now live from San Francisco. Guy.
Evening, Peter. AT&T Park is already returning to its usual baseball layout, but just a few hours ago it was the scene of even more Kiwi jubilation, with the All Black Sevens winning another world title.
Might just be shouting a little bit louder.
History makers in black.
New Zealand, enjoy!
New Zealand climbing to the top of the Sevens world again, beating England 33-12 in the final to become the first men's team to win back-to-back titles, adding to their Commonwealth Games gold medal.
We worked so hard for this the whole year when we targeted both pinnacle events, and to get the result is it's just huge.
The All Black Sevens scored first in the final.
Maria Mitchell.
And never relinquished that lead, two late tries sealing the emphatic victory. Earlier, they'd stunned hot favourites Fiji in the semi-final, that complete performance giving them belief they could go the whole way.
You know, in our eyes, we believed and we did it, so too easy.
They're the first team to win three Sevens World Cups after triumphs in 2001 and 2013 in Moscow. This one extra special for co-captain Scott Curry, who missed the last campaign through injury.
I guess it weighed on my mind a little bit. The fact that I missed out is really disappointing back then, but I mean, I'm just so stoked to be here and I'm so proud of how we played this weekend.
Also emotional for Dylan Collier, with his parents in the stands.
We missed out on the Commonwealth Games and we decided we couldn't miss another opportunity to watch him play. Just wanted him to have some family support.
It was awesome that they could make it over and experience this with me, but also, I've got my partner and my son back home as well. It's awesome that I could do this for them as well.
It couldn't be better for New Zealand rugby, claiming the men's and women's crowns in less than 24 hours. This baseball-turned rugby ground had no sevens history before this weekend, but it's now the scene of Kiwi domination. A black paradise with a golden glow, New Zealand sevens in a world of their own.
And going back to Guy in San Francisco now, two big days for the Kiwis. What's the atmosphere at the stadium there been like?
It's been quite electric throughout the weekend, Peter. The Americans came here, I think, not even knowing how to score a game of rugby. Well, most of them. But they've left as experts, I suggest. There's been a smattering of Kiwis throughout this park. We met a group of 10 of them who actually met up. They didn't know each other. They met up in Moscow when the All Black Sevens last won the World Cup. They came here together and they're now best of friends and saying they'll go to the next World Cup, hoping that the All Black Sevens win that as well. Just to note, the All Black Sevens arrive back in New Zealand on Wednesday morning. They are on the flight that lands at 5:30, so if you want to see them land, get down to Auckland International Airport and welcome them home.
Guy Hevelt in San Francisco. Thank you.